Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you how you can write a script that will simulate a form in Mac Numbers. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 500 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So in Numbers for iPad, you can create forms. So when you have a database like this and you want to add more items to it, more rows, you can switch into form mode and then enter these four pieces of data and it will add a new row. It's a really cool thing you can do on the iPad with Numbers, but unfortunately you can't do it on the Mac. However, we can simulate it using a script. So here I have a Numbers document. It has two sheets in it. And in sheet one, I've got a database, which is basically just a table, and each row is a record. And I can add to it by simply hitting return, entering more data here, like that. But what would be nice is to have a form to fill out instead. Now, for this simple example, it's really not necessary. But for other types of things, it may be. So in sheet two here, I've got a form. And this is basically just two tables. This first table here, I've just taken away all the borders and stuff and I've put in just some labels. The second table is just some blank cells. And you could format this any way you want and change the fonts and the borders and all of that. I just wanted to have a table here that is basically four blank spots and I can enter in data. So if I enter in some data here like that, then I would like to be able to just take an action and then this data is added to this database. And I can do that. I'm actually going to run it for you right now. And you could see it very quickly added that information there and cleared this out and got it all ready for me to enter in another entry. So how did I do that? Well, I used a script. Now you could do a script in Script Editor or Automator. I chose to use Script Editor for a few reasons, which you'll see. Here is the script. So let's go through it. Do note this is JavaScript, not AppleScript. You can switch between them here. So make sure if you're going to write this out or paste it in that you have selected JavaScript. It's pretty simple. There's not that many lines of code here. At the beginning, all I'm doing is setting some variables. I set numbers equal to the application. And then I get two tables from this document. So this script only works if this document's open. Otherwise it's going to throw an error. So the database variable I'm setting to numbers, documents, sheets, zero. So the first sheet because they start counting at zero. So sheets, zero. And then the table's named database. So you can see here that there's a title here, database. Then the second table is called form and I'm looking in the same document but sheet one. So the second sheet here. And the table named data entry. And if I go here, you don't see it, but if I select the table and then I look on the side here for table name, I turn that on, you can see it's named data entry. I just don't want to see it there, so I've hidden it. So now I've got those in two variables, database and form. Now I'm going to loop through the values here. So I'm going to set an array to blank, nothing, and I'm going to use a for loop and loop starting with zero. To the first cell and going until the end, the length of all of the rows here. So it'll be four and increasing each time. So just going through each of these, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Then I get the value from that. So form rows I, so the row, cell 0, so first column, and then value. Then I'm going to use push to put that onto the values array. So it starts value, starts at nothing, and then it's going to add four different values. Then it's going to go and work on this table. First thing I'm going to do is create a new row. And you can do that using add row below. And then the way you would do that is you want to refer to that table and then a cell. So in this case we'll do column A. Doesn't really matter which column. But then the row's length. So in other words there are 8 rows here. So this will actually be 8. So A8 add row below. So it's just going to basically add a row towards the bottom. If I had done something like A4 I would add a row after the fourth row. I wanted to add one to the bottom. Then I'm going to loop through all the values that I put in that array and set the value of each cell going across from each column to each of those values. So it's going to get four values there and it's going to set it to be 4 across. Then it's done its main task. But what I want it to do is then go back to this table here and I want it to set the value of each of these cells to blank. And I'm going to do it in a weird way. I'm going to start at the end. So the number of cells here -1 because it'll say there's 4 cells here in this column. So I want to start at cell 3 and then go backwards. That's why it's I minus minus instead of I plus plus. So it's going to loop backwards. So it's going to go 3, 2, 1, 0 and set them all to blank. The reason I'm doing it backwards is because what happens is the last cell that's set is then the one that is selected. Here I can actually type the data in, run the script, and then type in starting right away since this one would be selected. So that's what we've got. And all I did before when I showed you it working was I hit the run button and it ran. So I could just leave this script open here and hit the play button every time I wanted to record some data. But what I'm going to do instead is save it out so that I can access it by the menu bar. Notice here I've got a little script icon in the menu bar. I can put that there by going in Script Editor to Script Editor Preferences and checking Show Script Menu in Menu Bar. Once that's there, you'll see I've got Open Scripts Folder and I can open Script Editor Scripts Folder, User Scripts Folder, or Computer Scripts Folder. This would be for all the users on the machine. I want to do the User Scripts Folder just for me, my user here. And that will open up this Scripts folder here, which you could see is in the library. Then I've got an Applications folder there. If not, you can create one. And then under Applications, I can create a new folder. So let's create a new folder here. And I'm going to name it the same exact name as the app. So I'm going to call it Numbers. I'm going to make sure it's in the Applications folder there. So in Applications, I've got Numbers and Safari. The scripts stored in Numbers will only be available if I'm running Numbers, which is what I want here. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do Save As, and I'm going to save it here. So let me drag this into the Save dialog. So now I'm saving it there. Submit Form. So now you can see in the Scripts folder under Applications, under Numbers, I have a Submit Form. So I can close that and I can close this script here. And then if I look here in this menu, but first making sure that I'm running Numbers, I'll see Submit Form. It says Number Scripts. If I'm running something else, like say I'm going to switch to Finder here, you won't see that there. You have to be running Numbers. So there is Submit Form. So it's a menu choice. Now I can even create a keyboard shortcut for that. So now I can go and enter in more data. And now I can go there, Submit Form, and it will first ask me permission. It's only going to do this the very first time. And you can see it did it. It added that data there. So you can use this script as a starting point for doing more complex things. For instance, you can do things like making sure that numbers are numbers or they're between certain ranges. You can make sure that strings are a certain length and throw an error up there if it isn't right instead of inserting the data into the new row. Now the one thing this doesn't do is it doesn't allow you to edit data. But you can do some more complex scripts that do. For instance, you could have a form that actually pulls data from a row from the database and puts it in the form and then allows you to update that row. It would require having a bunch more extra cells and probably several different scripts that you can use to trigger different things like moving from row to row and updating the data from the form back to the database. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.